So you're wanting to create a contact form in HTML. If you need a helping hand or you find yourself running into some issues, don't stress, because we've broken down this process into 6 easy to follow steps. But make sure you stick around to the end of the video where we look at an easier no-code solution. Let's check it out. G'day everyone, Alex from Paperform here. Now, I understand that you're trying to create a contact form in HTML. So we decided to break down this process from start to finish into 6 easy to digest steps, starting with step number 1, choosing an HTML editor. Now, much like you need a word processor to create a text document, you need an HTML editor to create your code. And I use Visual Studio Code or VS Code. However, there is a vast number of options out there. So check out the description of this video where I've linked Paperform's jumbo list of web dev tools. Once you've taken a look, choose the text editor that's right for you, and let's continue on to step number 2, creating a basic HTML file. Now, you'll need to open your text editor for this. So once you've opened that, time to get down to business. Once you've opened it, create a new file and save it with the HTML extension. You can label your form however you like, but I'm going to label mine kick-ass contact form. Now, there we go. On to step number 3, adding some basic fields. Now, if you're new to HTML, this is where you'll need to pay attention, because the following might just look like some random numbers and symbols. You don't need to understand what they mean, but the creation process and troubleshooting of your code is obviously going to be that much easier if you have a grasp on the basics. Now, there are plenty of online guides that can introduce you as a beginner to HTML. So feel free to jump onto your browser and take a look at them. But if not, this video will give you a basic look at how you can build a contact form in HTML. Now, you're going to want to add the following code, which I have pasted in the video's description. And this will turn your current basic bones HTML into a contact form. Now, an HTML form is made up of form elements. These are the things like headings, tables, boxes, buttons, yada yada, and so on and so forth. Each element has its own specific tag, and that's the word in between the chevrons or angle brackets. The angle brackets are those V-shaped lines that you see here. For example, the HTML form tag, just there, defines your code as a form, while the table tag, we can see there, defines an HTML table. These elements are like shoes. They always come in pairs. Whenever you have an opening tag, you must have a closing tag. So let's run this current code and see what we've created so far, as it's always easier to understand our code when we can actually visualize it. So in your text editor, select run, and our basic HTML code has output the following. But how did our code create this? Well, notice in the code, the tag tr, this tells your form to arrange the elements in a row, while td, as you can see there, which stands for table data, signals that you want to capture whatever respondents type. In this instance, we've added 2 fields, first name and last name. But this is a contact form, so we need a field to allow the submitter to send a message. On to step number 4, adding an additional field. Now, we currently have a basic form asking respondents for their first name and last name. Take a look at the following code here. We can see that this code we use to create a text input field, more specifically our first name field. We can alter the code to create a message field, which is pretty important in a contact form. Let us change the question title from first name to message. Now, the input type will remain the same as it's still a text field. And let us change the field name from fname to message. Now, the field name value will be how you internally identify your field, so don't stress too much about this. Now, the most important thing to take away from this is the input field type. This tells the form how the responses should be formatted. And so the submitter will receive an error if they don't follow that format. If you want to add other question types and are unsure how to label the input type, W3Schools has an amazing list to guide you, which I have again included in the description of this video. Now, onto step number 5, adding placeholders. Placeholder text appears within a form field. It's basically a nudge in the right direction, telling your respondents how they should respond. Now, it's fairly simple to add a placeholder to your HTML contact form. After the input type of a question, just insert placeholder is equal to. Let me show what I mean. We'll find this. We'll jump to the message field and I'll put in placeholder equals quotation type your message, and then close that with another quotation. So for your message question type, I've added the field type your message. Let's quickly run our code and take a look at this on the front end. There we go. And we can see the placeholder has now been added. You can add this to any of your fields. But one thing we might notice is we don't have a submit button on this form. How is our submitter meant to submit it without a submit button? Easy. That's onto this final step, step number 6, adding a submit button. Much like you can include a question field by altering the input type, you can include a submit button this way as well. Go ahead and copy the following code that I've just pasted here, which again, you'll find in the video's description. And this will add a submit button. So if we hit run there, boom, we can see that submit button is added. Jumping back into the text editor, we'll notice we have the input type, which is, as we said, the type of field. And we also have a value. This will be the text shown within the button. Currently it's submit. So what if I change the value to drop us a line? Then I select run. Boom, we can see that our button text has changed. Easy, right? Now, I'm sure you're looking at this form and thinking, ugly, and you'd be right. We can both agree that we should not share this with our potential clients or customers because it doesn't exactly look too professional. So how can we beautify it? Well, if you have a basic understanding of HTML or CSS, go ahead. You no longer need me if you ever did. If not, take a look again at W3 Schools. We can learn how to code quickly. But while I still have your attention, may I ask why you want to go through the frustrating, long, and complex process of building your contact form through HTML, especially given the awesome no-code solutions that are out there? You can build beautiful contact forms, feedback forms, registration forms, quizzes, surveys, even e-commerce stores through these amazing platforms, and all without writing code. They've got the back-end power you want and the functionality that you need. But where should you start? Well, I believe Paperform to be the best of the bunch. You might think that's a biased opinion, but I do believe it. If you don't believe me, check it out. I'll jump onto Paperform and quickly create a form with those same fields we just used for our HTML contact form. There we go. And boom. Then I'll jump into the theme settings and with a few clicks change the look, feel and design of my form to better portray my brand or business. Let's take a look at that on the front end. Voila, how easy. We also offer a 14-day free trial with no credit cards required. So what are you waiting for? Head to the link in the description of this video, sign up and start creating some beautiful forms today. Good luck and have fun creating.